All right, Alan Betrayer. I'll spare you, but you best change your ways. I know Zachariah's amazing, and it's very easy to be jealous of him. He is a true mancer after all. But you cannot let your jealousy get the best of you. You must work on it. Uh-oh.
Damn. More ASC. We knew they had reached the city, so I can't say it's a surprise.
No, but I hope it's the last time we cross paths with Victor's grunts. I'm getting pretty sick of their faces.
Oh, damn. Don't worry, guys. We'll spank the ASC just like we always do. We'll take down their whole military force. They've got nothing on us. We have this cool technomancy music. This is quite pretty. What a lovely atmosphere. Alright guys, who's ready for a fight? Hehe. You get off me, Sha. Well, you weren't too hard now, were you? What's this guy? I love the way he looks. I want him to join my party. These ice dome creatures are cool. Let's just be friends. Come on, gang. Let's go make some new friends. I love my mancer powers. Well, it's a good moveset. But Zacharias is better. Oh, 2-on-1. Oh, now it's 2-on-2. My, why do you ever join me? Hey now. Why don't you fight me like a man? This is a face-to-face, fist-to-fist fight. Don't bring a gun to a fist fight. Aha! I knew we'd find more friends. Here they are. Just zap them all. This is like electrotherapy. And maybe they won't be so mean. And they'll join Zachariah. I definitely like it in here. All the ice hanging off the ceiling. They did quite a good job on their design. Da-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Let me up, I say. I'm trying to get up here. Oh, all you guys need electrotherapy. Or just therapy. Come on over here. I only charge $399 an hour. You won't be disappointed though. You can come see me twice a week. $399 an hour for the next 20 years. Then you'll be worse off than when you first came. That's a great deal. Alright, I have a 3-for-1 special. Hey! Just for you three. Heal up here. You guys can have a low price of $299 an hour. That's $299, mind you. Or 299 exploding traps per hour. I'll take either. It's called Mancer Therapy. I'll manch you better.
Zachariah Mancer. I was wondering if you'd make it this far. But I must admit you're particularly sharp. For a mutant. You are too late. I've already discovered the dark secret that your kind has hidden for so long. However, this city... amazing, isn't it? So full of wonders. A complex of keys to a brand new world.
That doesn't matter. You're not gonna live to see it.
Really? Do you intend to kill me? Like that poor boy Jeff? You won't get the opportunity. My men are a little bit on edge after what you did to their comrade. Now, if you would be so kind, I'm going to pry that last secret out of the belly of this city. The one that will give me a hero's welcome back at Abundance. And help me impose a new world order. Farewell, Zachariah. Chin up. Thanks to your hard work, Abundance will now have a bigger, brighter future.
A bigger? Brighter future.
Whatever, Victor. I'd rather be a mutant. And be all stuck up prejudice like you. And don't forget, super pretentious. Sure to talk dull for a villain, Victor. I'll kill all your flunkies, and I'm coming for you. Zachariah's sexy. If he's a mutant, and mutants are damn sexy too. Much rather have a mutant than you, Victor. Any day. Ooh, exploding traps. Just what I always wanted.
Sorry to bother you, but I'm gonna have to stop you right there.
I have to admit, even after everything, you are still full of surprises. Such tenacity. Your efforts are futile. Don't you understand? If not me, someone else is bound to reveal your secret. So why not use this revelation as an opportunity, as a chance to promote the corporation that raised you?
You're the one who doesn't realize he's playing with fire, and that even tyrants can burn.
We shall see.
Oh yeah, I'll burn you tyrants to the ground. Maybe I don't care if the world knows I'm a mutant. I'm proud to be a mutant. I like being different. Hey now. Easy, fella. Aw, man. I get knocked down. Can I get up again? You never gonna get me down. Alright, Victor. I'm watching you. Can we get some, Victor? Oh, crap. Okay, well, I'll get you next time for sure. Now that you did get some.
Sorry to bother you, but I'm gonna have to... You're the one who does...
We shall see.
You just got lucky that first time, Victor. You are not the veil. Hey! Get your little stooge off of me. Why don't you come and face me, Victor? Hide behind your giant stooges. Haha, you missed. Let's dance, son. I've got you in the bag this time. Oh, crap. Baby. I got it. Healed. I can still do this. With that exploding trap, fella. Walk on over it. Come on. Here, boy. Come on, over here. Explode, damn you. Come on, Victor. You can't even see it. Ha ha. Take that. Your flunky outlived you. I knew you were weak.
He's dead. Not by force, but by his health. How ironic, the commander of armies and the persecutor of thousands, sabotaged by his own heart.
That's a twist I'll live with.
God damn! What was that?
I can't say for sure, but I can feel the tremors from here. Let's move. Heart of the city, now.
That's the tyrant's karma for having such a judgmental, rotten heart. Up we go! So beautiful.
Zach, wait a sec.
What is it, Nisha?
What we're about to accomplish If we do contact Earth, living on Mars could be a choice, not a necessity. Would you want to leave? Abandon the Red Planet forever?
I haven't had the time to think about it. What would you do?
I don't know. I think my life is here, but I can't imagine living it without you. But I'll stop. We are on the verge of history. Come, let's make it together.
Oh, quit your worrying, Nisha. We can live anywhere and be happy. It's not about where you live, it's how you live. Not being all rotten-hearted, like Victor. Oh, cool. What in the world are you? You're awfully cool looking. I guess you wanna eat me, homeworm. If I cut you in half, will you still be alive? Ah. Let's find out. Hey, now, with swapping away their tail. Bad worm. Make love, not war. I'll teach you how to romance the other worms. Then you'll be the best mancer in town. You won't be so angry. She just, like, baffing me over the head all the time. Dun 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 dun. There's some rockin' music, worm. Certainly makes this exciting. Ah, don't eat me. You just use your body weight to fight, do you? I wouldn't be squashed at all if this giant worm came down on me that hard. But it squashed me like a bug. I would just get up over and over. Like I'm doing. Don't try to poison me now. Guess he's hungry. Got your eyes closed. Oh. finally dwindling you down. Gonna have to face this worm head on. Jeez. What are you, a whip? It just uses his whole body as a whip. Hey! I'll whip you. Ha! Don't kill me. It took me too long to get this far. Oh, yes. Yeah. Down, boy. Phew. That was one hard worm.
Surely the beacon is here. This place is breathtaking. The ice has preserved it well.
This place is breathtaking. I agree, Mancer. Wholeheartedly agree. You're a wise beyond your years. I'll get that beacon.
Initializing search system display. Connection to Earth in progress. Connection failed. Extrapolating incomplete data. Updating solar system display.
Destroyed. Earth is gone. All these years wasted dreaming of a rescue from a place that's nothing but a cloud of scattered rocks. Everyone on Mars, if they hear of this, they'll be devastated. What am I gonna tell them?
That's a good lesson for them. Tell them they have to learn how to save themselves, not wait around to be saved by someone else.
What would you do if you were me, Phobos?
I would reveal everything. The truth is not comforting, but it has proven us right. We decided to build our future here on the Red Planet, our planet, because there is nothing waiting for us out there. It's just a shame that humans haven't done the same. Show your true face to the world. Let the humans throw their tantrums and come join us in Mutant Valley. You and the Technomancers could help us turn our city into a nation. And together, we could make the world a paradise where everyone can be proud of who they are, not ashamed of what they are. After all, aren't we brothers?
Yes, we are brothers, my love. And I agree with you completely. I will tell everybody and join you. We will build a beautiful life together. Free and open. It will be lovely.
It's time for the truth. There'll be no more hiding. No more secrets. I'm gonna tell them of Earth's destruction and reveal the true identity of every single Technomancer on the planet. This news will send shockwaves across Mars, but it's the first step for changing our planet. For the better. Let's go. Mutant Valley awaits. Looking back now, I bet I wouldn't even recognize the young Zachariah Mancer who just earned his stripes.
And little did I know that all my choices would compound together and shape the city under the ice. By allowing Bulgakov safe passage out of the city, the Resistance survived and thrived, and their support later proved invaluable. Despite my orders, I couldn't bring myself to kill my fellow man, and I let the deserters and their leader go, only to find that one day, he would return the favor. I remember letting poor Dave go, understanding he only betrayed me to protect his family. Meanwhile, a more dangerous spy was hiding in my shadow. Despite everything Jeffrey did to me, I couldn't let Nisha shoot him down like a dog. And even in all my efforts to be a good soldier, I was still exiled from Ophir. No matter what happened, Victor was always going to discredit me. Yet my decisions of friends, alliances, would greatly influence the events that followed. The day I left Ophir in a stolen rover was the day I had chosen the people alongside me to become my companions, through adventure, misfortune, and into battle. Later, I agreed to help Dandolo chase the Vori out of Noctis, for good, cutting them off at the bridgehead they hoped to use to infiltrate every settlement on Mars. And because of that, Anton came close to paying the ultimate price when his men picked him as the scapegoat. But he's not a man you get rid of that easily. By becoming the great master of Technomancers, I've earned their unwavering loyalty. But I've also accepted a lifelong responsibility. Since I've left the city under the ice, I've had many young apprentices, and the Order is powerful again, our future bright. Scum keeps the young mutant nation alive and well, and with Phobos' help, he has managed to repel Corporation's troops, time and time again. And with the incoming surge of refugees, you'd be a fool to bet against Mutant Valley. It's destined to become the most powerful force on Mars. Nisha still runs missions for Dandolo, but I can tell her heart's not in it. I think she's beginning to see that her father figure, as charming and caring as he may appear to be, is really a master manipulator that won't hesitate to make less than ethical choices to serve the best interests of his city. I don't mind. It gives me more time to spend with warm, loving, beautiful, real Nisha, and less time with cold, calculating, and, okay, still beautiful super spy Nisha. And she's finally starting to sing again, and I dabble in harmony. To this day, I wonder if I was right in allying with Anton. The Vori are spread across the planet, their power unmatched, unchecked, and they run their operations in broad daylight. Corruption has spiked, even after the Colonel's demise, and all the gifts and wealth I receive, compliments of Anton, don't stop me from feeling like I sold out. I worry about the future of Abundance. It may well end up with a rogue for its leader. The opposition showed its strength when it helped me overthrow Victor, and the people have rewarded them with several seats in the assembly. Now, they promote their same ideals, but do so in a more legal fashion. I'm afraid that with their repeated outbursts, they're on a collision course with the violent side of human nature. But I admire their passion. Yet nothing compared to my revelations. Learning that Earth was destroyed, discovering that Technomancers were mutants crafted in the vision of the settlers. When I announced the truth, the corporations lashed out. There were widespread riots and revolts, and most Technomancers fled before the leaders of the Alliance could put the pieces together. To adapt to Mars, we had to mutate, or we wouldn't survive. Remaining human had only been an illusion, and one that we had unknowingly mastered. I heard that a few scientists have reproduced Scott's experiments, and I have no doubt there'll be more of us in the future. One day, Mutant Valley won't be the only place a mutant can call home. Instead, it'll be the capital for a race spread across Mars. At least that's what I hope.
What a fun game. I really enjoyed it. Thanks so much for watching, everybody. Please do subscribe. Bye-bye.